வணக்கம். ஹலோ ஃப்ரெண்ட்ஸ், இன் ஸ்டோரி டைம் அட் கடம்பவனம் டுடே வி வில் சி தி ஸ்டோரி ஆஃப் சுந்தரமூர்த்தி நாயனார். இன் தி கண்ட்ரி ஆஃப் திருமுனைப்பாடி, இன் த ஹோலி டவுன் ஆஃப் திருநாவலூர், தேர் லிவ்ட் அ பயஸ் கப்பிள், சடையனார் அண்ட் இசைஞானியார். தேவர் பிளெஸ்ட் வித் அ பேபி பாய் ஹூம் தே நேம்ட் நம்பி ஆரூரன். The child grew up into a beautiful and holy boy, and one day while the child was playing in the streets, the king of the Chola country, Narasingha Munayar, came by the side and saw him. So attracted was he by the boy that he approached the father and requested that he be allowed to take the boy to the palace and bring him up as if he were his own son. The father, Sadayanar, accepted, and Nambi Arurar was taken to the palace, and he was brought up in the Vedic traditions to which he belonged, learning all the arts and the Vedas, and soon Nambi Arurar came of marriageable age. Sadayanar found a suitable bride in the neighboring city of Puttur, the daughter of Sadangavi Sivacharyar. The wedding date was fixed, and Nambi Arurar was adorned with all jewels and beautiful costumes and taken in a procession to Puttur. The fair maidens who received him were awed by the beauty of Nambi Arurar and said, "How lucky is this daughter of Sadangavi Sivacharyar to be marrying this beautiful Sundarar." At that very moment in Mount Kailash, Sivaberman was getting ready to descend to the earth and go to Puttur, and as he had already promised that he will intervene in the life of Sundarar at the right moment to claim him as his own, he came down to the earth disguised as an old Brahmin priest. He approached the wedding place and went straight up to the groom, and much to the astonishment of those surrounding him, looked at Nambi Arurar and said, "Hey Nambi, you and I have a score to settle. Stop the wedding and come with me." Everybody was shocked, and Nambi Arurar said, "What is this you're talking about?" The old Brahmin said, "You are my slave, and I have proof of this. Not only you, but all your generations have been my slaves. Nambi Arurar was shocked and asked for proof. Sivaberman said, I have proof of this. And he took out a palm leaf script and showed it to everyone around and said, "Here it is written that Nambi Arurar and all his generations are my slaves." As soon as he saw that palm leaf, Sundarar jumped at it and Sivaberman started moving. Sundarar ran behind him, plucked the manuscript out of Lord Shiva's hands and tore it up into pieces. Lord Shiva was furious and he said, "Isn't this proof enough to say that he is my slave? Well, this is only a copy. I have the original manuscript at my hometown." People asked him from where he came and he said, "I come from Thiruvennainallur." So it was decided that everybody, including Nambi Arurar, would accompany the Lord to Thiruvennainallur and take up the case there. The entourage arrived at Thiruvennainallur, upon which the Lord brought out the original manuscript, and the case was heard in front of an august gathering. He showed the manuscript wherein it was written, "Myself and all my generations will forever serve thee," and it was signed Arurar. Now this signature was proved as the signature of Nambi Arurar's grandfather. So then the case was settled and it was decided that yes, indeed, Nambi Arurar had to go with the old priest. At that point, people there asked the priest, "You say you are from Thiruvennainallur. Where is your house?" The Lord said, "Well, you all follow me and I will lead you to my home." And he went straight to the temple of Thiruvarul and went inside. Everybody followed him. The next minute, he disappeared. Nambi Arurar was astonished And he went inside searching for the old priest. And there, behold, on the resplendent Nandi were sitting Lord Shiva and his consort Parvati. Lord Shiva reminded Sundarar of his earlier life and mentioned how he had come to reclaim his beloved Sundarar. Sundarar was filled with ecstasy and was humbled by the love that the Lord had showered him with. And Lord Shiva asked Sundarar to hence sing his praise in the holy language of Tamil. Not knowing where to start, Sundarar asked the Lord to help him out. Sundarar had called the Lord Pitta, meaning, "Oh, crazy fellow." So Lord Shiva said, "Why don't you start with the very name by which you called me, Pitta?" And Sundarar broke into the hymn, "Pitta Piraisodi." Pitta Piraisodi Perumane Arulalai Yetta Mara Vade Nine Kindren Manadunne Vaitai Penne Tenpal Venne Nallur Arul Thorayul Atta Unak Alayini Allen Yenalame and went on to compose verses in love of his Lord. Thus begins the story of Sundarar, which we will continue in our next episode. Thank you.